At first glance, Camp Polk Meadow looks healthy, with a lovely creek flowing through the valley. The meadow is home to wildlife. The water is not polluted. The creek banks are lined with trees. It is, to our eyes, a typical northwestern landscape.
Today we've become accustomed to seeing Whychus Creek flow in an unnaturally straightened channel along the edge of the meadow. But historically, Whychus Creek used to flow as a meandering path through the meadow, providing really high-quality fish and wildlife habitat.
At the turn of the century, homesteaders arrived in Sisters, Oregon, and Camp Polk Meadow was the first recorded settlement.
Well, the homesteaders that came here came in 1870, and they were trying to use the meadow to produce crops, especially grains, which were the gasoline of that time, for their animals.
Settlers arrived to a lush meadow with abundant fish and wildlife, edible plants, and cold, clean water. Whychus Creek flows out of the Cascade Mountains through steep boulder canyons, rushing past pine forests toward the community of Sisters, Oregon. For another 22 miles, the creek flows through arid ranch land and high desert before it joins the Deschutes River. Historically, thousands of salmon and steelhead traveled hundreds of miles from the Pacific Ocean to spawn in Whychus Creek, including the premier spawning grounds at Camp Polk Meadow. Over the last 100 years, the creek was increasingly tapped for irrigation. In time, it began running dry during the hot summer months.
I cannot find fault with those folks who took all the water. They needed it to make a living, to grow their crops, and for domestic use. They didn't have to take it all, but in those days, everyone's mindset was, it'll last forever.
In the 1960s, Whychus Creek was fundamentally changed, and much of the outstanding habitat was lost. The creek that once meandered through the meadow was pushed to the side of the valley, turned into a straight, deep, eroding channel. At the same time, hydroelectric dams were being built on the Deschutes River, blocking the path for migrating fish. Eventually, salmon and steelhead no longer reached Whychus Creek. When the area was up for sale, the Deschutes Land Trust saw a different future for this meadow.
Well, the landowner had subdivided the property into, I believe, 7 home sites, and each of those home sites had a small piece of the meadow. And it looked like, at that time, that the meadow was going to be forever broken into pieces. But because the landowner was patient and willing to work with us, because Portland General Electric was willing to work with us, we had the time to put a deal together that allowed us to acquire the 145 acres down in the meadow. As a result, we're able to now re-meander the creek and, we hope, reestablish a very important run of steelhead and salmon.
Deschutes Land Trust sought the expertise of the Upper Deschutes Watershed Council and Deschutes National Forest to manage, design, and implement the restoration project.
By restoring this area, we have the opportunity to restore high-quality habitat, provide cold, clean water, and help support the return of steelhead for the first time since the 1960s.
When complete, the project will return nearly 2 miles of Whychus Creek to its historic location, meandering through Camp Polk Meadow, restoring 35 acres of wetlands and more than 100,000 native plants.
The reintroduction of salmon and steelhead is very much focused in the Whychus Creek watershed, and the Camp Polk area was historically very important for steelhead in the Whychus Creek area. So restoring habitat here at Camp Polk actually helps support that larger reintroduction effort.
It is going to take 10 years, numerous volunteers, and almost $2 million to complete this project. The effort won't be easy or neat or quick. There will be noise and dust and temporary disruptions to wildlife, and it will be a few years before the native habitat is fully restored. But for many, it is worth it. It represents an opportunity to see the meadow and creek through a new lens. As a home for wildlife where nature can run its course, a place where Whychus Creek can flow freely. The Upper Deschutes Watershed Council sought help from the Deschutes National Forest to devise a restoration plan for the Deschutes Land Trust's Camp Polk Meadow Preserve.
The Deschutes Land Trust early on decided that we wanted to restore as much of our 145-acre preserve as possible. So not just do restoration for the fish, but also the wildlife here. Then decided ultimately that by returning the stream to its historic floodplain, that would be the best way to achieve that goal.
The Forest Service referenced 1943 aerial photos and other historic information to understand how the creek has changed over time, then headed out for months of field evaluations.
We dug this test pit a couple of years ago to check and make sure that the gravels were where we thought they would be. Those are the gravels. That's our spawning habitat. You can tell that material used to be at the bottom of a creek bed. That's exactly what we're going to be accessing when we bring the channel back here.
The construction team will weave 1.3 miles of new stream channel through the meadow.
These meadows act like big sponges. During the rainy season, they absorb water. During the dry summer season, that water is slowly released into the creek, providing a really good source of cold, clean water that helps improve fish habitat.
Twists and turns create pools for fish, and regular flooding helps support streamside trees and shrubs. Over time, the restored creek, complete with its abundant fish habitat, newly created wetlands, and lush meadow will slowly take shape.
In phase one, 2009, what we're focused on is basically digging the channel, adding water to it, and then planting it. And we're really trying to set up the basic structure of the new channel. Then we'll come back a couple years later and finish the job by redirecting the creek into the new channel and allowing that new channel to flow.
The excavation team, which specializes in stream restoration and wetland construction, works steadily as it moves through the landscape, slowly transforming the dry, dusty meadow back into what will one day again be the home of a meandering, life-nourishing creek.
Restoration of this scale definitely carries with it some inherent impacts, and so we've just been working really closely with our restoration partners and with the crews that are out on the ground making the project happen to ensure that we protect those resources, and they're just doing an incredible job.
Guiding the construction, Paul Powers with the Forest Service assembles whole trees of all shapes and sizes into natural-looking log jams.
These are just providing the structure to keep it in place for a while until that riparian community can develop and then let it be a dynamic system after that.
The logs serve as the backbone of the creek, providing erosion control and fish habitat. As the days pass, the new creek channel slowly begins to take shape. Over the course of 8 weeks, the construction team moves more than 30,000 cubic yards of soil and 600 whole trees as it crafts Whychus Creek's new course through Camp Polk Meadow.
Historically, the creek used to run dry. It ran dry as a result of stream flows dropping, large irrigation withdrawals that took place through the work of the Deschutes River Conservancy. We've seen a real increase in stream flows. As water rights have been acquired and put back in stream, water has been leased from landowners who don't need those waters. It's been a critical part of this reintroduction and the restoration of this watershed.
A trickle of water through the new channel will slowly start to recharge the meadow, provide moisture for the new plants, and prepare the channel to be completed in 2012.
We've already seen just huge increase in the amount of birds coming in since we've brought the water in. And it's just really fun to watch how the meadow is already changing before us, even in the midst of the construction.
To judge by what's happened over here with the willows, maybe that kind of intervention in 10 or 12 years with water added from the creek can create something that will look to our eyes, at least, like what we think we would have seen before those first homesteaders came.
The short-term impact on this landscape will lead to a long-term, healthy and wild place, a landscape restored, nurtured, and growing. Soon, the creek will meander through the meadow with clean, cool water, just as it might have hundreds of years ago.